Hello and welcome to my channel Shifa's Kitchen. Today I am going to show you how to make mutton dabba gosh. It is a Parsi recipe. So let's start. For this I have 250 grams of mutton, half a cup of boiled noodles, here you can use macaronis. Then I have 1/4 cup of almonds and 1/4 cup of cashews. In the restaurant they use corn flour, but I am using the dry fruits. Then we'll need one tomato and one capsicum sliced, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, 2 garlic crush, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1 small onion finely chopped. Then I have some whole spice, 1 cinnamon stick, 4 peppercorns, 4 cloves, 2 eggs, half a cup of curd. Then I have finely chopped coriander and mint leaves, also salt to taste, and half a teaspoon of black pepper. Now in the cooker I'll add almost 1.5 cup of water. If you like my video, please do subscribe to my channel and hit the notify button to get notified whenever I upload a video. Now to this I'll add mutton, then to this I'll add onions, to this I'll add ginger garlic paste. And a whole spice, cinnamon stick. To this we'll add salt, give it a mix and let it cook. Now we'll cover it with lid and let it cook for about 1/2 hour. Mutton is done. Now don't throw the stock, we'll need it later on. In the meanwhile, we'll make the powder of almonds and cashews. As you can see, the powder is done. Now in the wok I'll add desi ghee, almost 2 tablespoons. Let it melt. Then to this I'll add cumin seeds and our grated garlic. Mix it and let the garlic turn a bit brown. If you like my recipe, please give a thumbs up. Also, if you have any suggestion or request to make, please feel free to comment down below and do subscribe. Our garlic has turned a bit brown. To this I'll add cashew and almond paste. In the powder I have added a bit of water and then I have processed it. Sorry, the video got deleted. Mix it and let it cook for 2 minutes. Now to this I'll add salt and black pepper. Add salt accordingly, since we have added salt in the stock too. Mix it properly. Then to this we'll add the stock with the mutton. Mix it properly and let it cook for about 3 to 4 minutes. Now to this I'll add slit green chilies 2. Then to this I'll add hung curd. Then to this I'll add finely chopped mint leaves and green coriander. Mix it and let it cook for about 3 to 4 minutes. Now to this we'll add boiled noodles. If you want, you can add green peas, carrots, French beans boiled, but I am not adding it here. In the restaurant they add cornstarch slurry to make it thick, but I am not adding it over here. If you want, you can add it. Our gravy is done and it is of the right consistency. Now we'll transfer it in a bowl and then we'll assemble it. Now we'll place our tomatoes. Then we'll add bell pepper green in the center. And on the sides, simultaneously we'll crack 2 eggs in a bowl. Then to it I'll add a bit of salt and black pepper, and then we'll mix them. Now on it we'll add our beaten egg. Over it we'll add a bit of green coriander and mint leaves finely chopped. We'll heat ghee almost 3 tablespoons and it should be very hot. Let it melt. As you can see, our ghee is like piping hot. We'll pour it over the egg so that the egg will get cooked. If the egg is like a bit uncooked or raw, just heat it in the microwave for about 1 to 2 minutes and it will be done. Mutton dabba gosht is ready. If you like my video, please give a thumbs up. Do comment and share my video. Subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I upload a new video. Support my efforts. Thank you.